This is the demonstration of tympanometry. And tympanometry is the assessment of the tympanic membrane and the middle ear. And this is a tympanometer. This is a screening tympanometer. There are several different kinds, but this one is a screening one. It has several different parts. There is some buttons right here, a display screen right here, and a probe. And right here is the probe. The probe has several different parts. It has a loudspeaker that emits a low-frequency probe tone into the external auditory canal. It also has an air pressure manometer that can change the air pressure in the external auditory canal. And it also has a microphone that picks up that low-frequency probe tone from the external auditory canal. And this is what we call a probe tip. It's important to get the correct size of probe tip so we can create an airtight seal in the external auditory canal because we can't do the test without an airtight seal. So I'm going to put the probe tip on the probe, just like that. So here is a model of the ear. Here's the pinna, the external auditory canal, the tympanic membrane, the middle ear space, and the inner ear. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place the probe into the opening of the external auditory canal. Then a low frequency tone will be presented into the external auditory canal. It'll travel through it. It'll hit the tympanic membrane, and some sound energy will be absorbed by the middle ear and travel into the inner ear, and some sound energy will be reflected back and picked up by the microphone in the probe. So basically what we're doing is we are assessing the efficiency of sound traveling through the middle ear. And if there were a middle ear pathology, such as a middle ear infection, where there's fluid in the middle ear space right here, the tympanic membrane will be stiffened, and as the sound travels through the ear canal and hits the tympanic membrane, less energy will be absorbed by the middle ear, and more energy will be reflected back and picked up by the probe. But on the other hand, if we had a pathology such as a break in the ossicular chain, more of that sound energy would be absorbed and less sound would be picked up at the microphone. This is the demonstration of the procedure of tympanometry. And the first thing that you're going to do is a physical examination of the external auditory canal and tympanic membrane. And that's called otoscopy. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to look in your ears.
Okay.
So if at any point you feel uncomfortable, just let me know. I'm going to pull your ear up and back. Okay, looks good. This test is called tympanometry. And what we're doing is we're assessing the function of your tympanic membrane and your middle ear. So what I'm going to be doing is placing this little tip in the opening of your ear canal. You're going to feel a little bit of pressure, like you're going up over a mountain or up in an airplane, but you don't have to do anything at all. All you have to do is sit still and quiet for me.
Okay.
Okay? This is an example of a normal tympanogram with an ear canal volume of 1.5, a static acoustic admittance of 0.8, and negative 15 decapascals. And you can see that it has a peak there, and that's normal as well. Okay, after you're finished, you can print out the results, and here is an example of what the results may look like.